praise to the Heavenly Father, Yahweh. In the name of His beloved Son, Yahweh Shai Nazareth, who sit at the right hand side of the throne of the Most High. We'll begin in Hebrews 11. Hebrews 11. Did I say 7?
11.
Yeah, Hebrews 11 and the 6th verse. So we can deal with this topic pertaining to faith. He that cometh to the Most High must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of them that diligently seek Him. That's the topic. Faith. So last, when new moon, we went into Eleazar, a man who had a resolute spirit, endured in the faith. The other night, we spoke about Paul, another brother that had a resolute spirit, enduring in the faith. We'll get into history. When our people was in the wilderness, and that's where we at as a people. We're in the wilderness again, okay? So we have to endure. There is no Christ come back, gather up Israel, take them to some wilderness place, and then prove Israel. That's not the scripture. That's a man-made breakdown, a devil's doctrine that's floating in the earth that has been given to our people. But Israel think they're going to be camping in some wilderness and being proved by the Lord. So, but right now, Israel is rehearsing the righteous acts of the Lord. We spin in scriptures, okay? And we scream at Yahweh Shai, but doing our own thing, being presumptuous. And that's a very bad spirit to have. And that spirit is in Israel, where we're self-willed, we're presumptuous. We cut up, we talk smack, we speak against the Most High in Christ. And we're going to have to give account of it, because the Most High is not just a God of mercy, He's also a God of judgment. So we scream love, love, love. Listen, we got to repent. So this is Hebrews 11 and 6, and it reads, "But without faith it is impossible to please Him." You see that? So we have to have the faith, Israel. We have to believe in the word of the Lord. We have to believe in God's promises, His covenants, His oaths. We have to believe in these scriptures, because we're going to have to answer at the end of this. So if we don't have the faith, we're not going to please the Most High in Christ, because we don't believe in His word. So it's telling us, but without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For he that cometh to the Most High must believe that He is. So when we step foot and come to the Most High through Christ, we have to believe that the Most High exists. He's a living power, a power who's merciful, but also He's one that will bring judgment. So we have to be about repentance. That's the doctrine of Christ, repentance. It's cool knowing we Israel. Listen, our people in the wilderness knew they was Israel. They knew what tribe they was from. They spoke Hebrew, and they got dealt with. So they were being carnal. They were cutting up in every situation. The Lord was bringing them into a case to bring things out. So we be screaming, we Israel, fringed up, all type of stuff. Then we get in these cases and situations, we fold. So we got to believe that the Most High exists, and that He is a rewarder of them that diligently, see that? Seek Him. So we have to believe, Israel, that the Most High, at the end of this thing, if we endure in the keeping of the commandments through Christ, being resolute, we will be rewarded for it. We will be blessed. Not just on this side, but in the kingdom with new bodies, eternal life, immortality, a heavenly kingdom. That's going to be right here on this earth, because when we do the Lord Prayer, we say, "Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven." See? There's a kingdom coming to you, Israel. But we got work to do. We have to labor. You see that? And us keeping the Sabbath, which Sabbath means rest, that foreshadows the kingdom of heaven. So we can't keep the Sabbath day right and the new moons and the feast days right. That show you how we're looking at God's kingdom. You read that in Hebrews 4. There's no, this brother can do his thing. Now I can do my thing. And that's being presumptuous, self-willed. That's not the scriptures. And then the minute we correct it, we mad, but we Israel. I like the tone of the brother or the sister, boy. Murmuring, speaking evil, elders, and all this other stuff. That's not the scriptures. We don't get into our history, brother. The Lord was not pleased with our nation. He could have easily brought us out of Egypt and took us right into the land like that. No, he said, no, they're going through the wilderness. They're going to be proven to see if they will keep my commandments or no. And we've seen the power of the Most High, brothers and sisters. The Lord had a cloud that would follow us, guide us, and lead us. It'd be a pillar by day, cloudy pillar by day, and it'll change at night to fire, a pillar of fire. And we still was cutting up. We was the people that seen the Red Sea open up. We still cutting up. We was the people that was getting manna every day, besides the way it wouldn't come down on the Sabbath before we go out and gather, and we still cutting up. Being fed quail, we still cutting up. We the people of the Most High talked to personally coming through four gates, and we still cut up. That's our nation. We Israel. Cutting up on Facebook, cutting up on the streets, cutting up at the movies, cutting up at home, cutting up at the parks. We like to cut up. We Israel. So let's get it. Let's go to Numbers, the first chapter. So we dealing with faith. And we have to believe that the Most High Christ exists, and that we will be rewarded if we diligently seek him. Numbers chapter 1. And 44. Numbers 1 and 44. We'll read about brothers who did keep the faith. Numbers 1 and 44. These are those that were numbered, which Moses and Aaron numbered, and the princes or leaders of Israel, being 12 men. Each one was for the house of his fathers. So were all those that were numbered of the children of Israel by the house of their fathers, from 20 years old and upward, all that were able to go forth to war in Israel. Even all they that were numbered were 600,000, and 3,550. So we're reading a number right there. When Aaron and Moses went out, they numbered these Israelites from 20 years old and upward. It was over 600,000 of them. Then they all proud and died. You go to the Apocrypha. Ecclesiasticus 16, which is a part of the 1611 edition of the King James. You can find this book in there. Some of us have that Bible. So Ecclesiasticus 16 show you the Most High is a God of judgment. And a lot of times we think, okay, we ain't got jacked up yet. Let us cut up, act a fool. The Lord is long-suffering. When the Lord says it's a done deal, it's a wrap, it's a wrap. Ain't no return to judgment, Lord, it's over. When he sent Christ back, the Most High ain't gonna say, stop, hold up, Christ, come back, let's give him another year. It's a wrap, man. So this Ecclesiasticus 16 and 9, you can read the chapter. It said he pitied not the people of perdition who were taken away in their sins. What is sin? The breaking of God's many commandments. 1 John 3 and 4. So we got two dots after sin. It said Noah, the 600,000 footmen who were gathered together in the hardness of their hearts. We just read, we're reading about them today. Do you see? The Lord will bring forth judgment on these Israelites here because they were proud. Verse 11 says, and if there be one stiff neck among the people, it is marvel if he escape unpunished. For mercy and wrath are with him. He is mighty to forgive and to pour out displeasure. See, the Lord is balanced. As his mercy is great, so is his correction also. He judges a man according to his works. See that? So we're going to be judged according to our works, our actions. We want that righteous reward. How are we going to get that righteous reward? By diligently seeking him, having the faith, being resolute in spirit, being about the will of the Most High, keeping it basic. We're not supposed to be about conformity. We're not supposed to be entertaining other doctrines. Scriptures say a fool changes as the moon. Here you got a brother and sister each month, they in some different doctrine. It's changing. When Christ, it said Christ was the same today, yesterday, and forever, tomorrow. How go?
Same yesterday and
yeah, you read about Christ changing, forgot what he told the Israelites over there in Jerusalem, then he go up to Galilee and say something different. Like Christ is bipolar, Paul bipolar, they forget what they said. It's only one doctrine. Israel all in these different doctrines, and then just in case the Lord judge, look, at least I was fellowshipping with this group, and that group, go with the Mormons, fellowship with them. Nah, they got a devil doctrine. Go to Catholic. Nah, devil doctrine. What about these Israelites? What doctrine they got? Nah, we Israel. Playing games, man. Playing games. We're not supposed to be changing as the moon, man. We don't want to let the heathen go, Israel. Let them go. Get rid of all of them, the book of Jasher, the book of Enoch, the pseudepigrapher. That's all leading our people astray. Keep it simple. What did Christ use to fight the devil? The scriptures. When the apostles taught, what were they pulling from?
Psalms, long prophets.
Thank you. When Christ told them to go out and teach, where did he take them to? The Psalms, the prophets, right? Beginning where? At Moses. Genesis, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Exodus, on all the way through. What we do? We want to be so deep as a people. Run around Israel unseated, which they already do, wearing yarmulkes and all this other stuff, eating eggs for Passover, telling Israel they got to eat an egg on Passover. How many wearing the Star of David? That ain't in the scriptures, isn't there? Where's it at, brother? Pomegranates. Leave the doobies alone. See? We poor people that's proud, man. Lord telling us, listen, I gave straight commandments, such to those that came, what they should do to avoid punishment, and what they should do to live. Did he not? You see? He tells us how to keep his commandments. He shows us how to keep the Sabbath day. He shows us how to put on our clothing, how to wear it. You brothers talking about the blue border is supposed to be violet. How do you get that in some other book? God know the Hebrew. Paul had a hard time with those that knew the Hebrew. Read the scriptures. They wanted to kill him. The circumcision. We read that the other night. They was stumbling at the stumbling stone. So the Lord tells us right here that this 600,000 footmen, that little group, they got dealt with being proud. Now, let's go to Numbers 13. Numbers 13. Who wanna read? I'll read it. There we go.
Numbers 13. I'll read it.
We can start at 1. Numbers 13, the first verse. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, send thou men that they may search the land of Canaan, which I give unto the children of Israel. So the Lord had already promised that he was giving our nation the land of Canaan. That would be our rest, our homeland. But that was a temporary rest, because the Lord spoke about another rest to come, and that's the kingdom of heaven through Christ. So at this time, the Lord said, Moses, go send out men that's gonna spy out this land, this inheritance that I'm gonna give Israel. Go ahead. It says, of every tribe of their fathers shall ye send a man, every one a ruler among them. Because it's going to show you that the father is the one who carries the seed and dictates the child's tribe. Go ahead. And Moses, by the commandment of the Lord, sent them from the wilderness of Paran. All those men were heads of the children of Israel. So when these men would go out, would they be somebody that's not influential in Israel? Or men of influence?
That would be men of influence.
Men of influence. So keep that in mind. Now, the Lord knows what he's doing. He sent out some heads, men of influence, sent them out to spy out the land. Go ahead.
Four verse. And these were their names. Of the tribe of Reuben, Shammuah, the son of Zaccur. Of the tribe of Simeon, Shaphat, the son of Hori. It says of the tribe of Judah, Caleb, the son of Jephunneh.
So he got Caleb. This brother will be a head from the tribe of Judah, the same tribe David would be from, Solomon, Christ. Read on.
Of the tribe of Issachar, Egal, the son of Joseph. Of the tribe of Ephraim, Osei, the son of Nun.
And that's Joshua. Go ahead.
Of the tribe of Benjamin, Paltiel, the son of Raphu. Of the tribe of Zebulun, Gadiel, the son of Sorai. Of the tribe of Joseph, namely of the tribe of Manasseh, Gadai, the son of Susai. Of the tribe of Dan, Amiel, the son of Gemali. Of the tribe of Asher, Sethur, the son of Micah. Of the tribe of Naphtali, Nabi, the son of Uspar, Osai. Of the tribe of Gad, Guel, the son of Makai. These are the names of the men which Moses sent to spy out the land. And Moses called Osei the son of Nun, Jehoshua.
All right, that's Joshua, Yahushua. See, so these are the spies right here. We ain't got nothing to do with no 12 tribe sign. Israel read that 12 tribe sign. Man-made doctrine again. And it ain't it's by design that they got Judah at the top, Issachar at the bottom. That's by design. And it's a sign filled with hate, man.
That's right.
The division. The darker tribes at the top. And then that's just foolish, Israel. What's wrong with that? We showing Israel their nationality. No, no, no. You go to the scriptures. See, we gotta be that people that believe in the Bible and the Bible alone. That's it. That's it. We ain't trying to hear some angels came down, got kicked out of heaven, still being the sons of God, laying with women. The angels don't have seed, man. Nor do they start a race. A race is started by the seed of man. That's in the scriptures. Things start with a seed, even in earth. But somewhere, somehow, how we said, angels lay with women, then you got a race of giants that's 450 feet piping women. Are you serious? Where did you get that from?
The nations of the books.
Those books. Those books. Virgin birth. Those books. See that? So we read about men of influence. This is key. Read on.
17th verse. And Moses sent them to spy out the land of Canaan, and said unto them, get you up this way southward, and go up into the mountain, and see the land what it is, and the people that dwelleth therein, whether they be strong or weak, few or many, and what the land is that they dwell in, whether it be good or bad, and what cities they be that they dwell in, whether in tents or in strongholds, and what the land is, whether it be fat or lean, whether there be wood therein or not, and be of good courage.
Be of what?
Of good courage.
See that? So Moses said, listen, brothers, go check out the land. And look at it in detail. Give us word. Be of good courage, Israel. See? Because this truth takes a lot of courage to deal in. Go ahead.
It says, and bring of the fruit of the land. Now the time was the time of the first ripe grapes.
See that? So right there, it just so happened to be the time of the first ripe grapes when Moses said this in the land of Canaan. And it ain't just what Moses said, bring the fruit. The Lord know what's going on. He ain't telling Moses what to say. It's the Spirit. See that? Bring the facts back, Jack. Because the Most High is cold-blooded. He know what he was giving us. He know what he giving us this time. Now people think the Lord all got ears where he can't hear. He hear the noise of murmuring, all type of stuff. Continue.
It says, 21st verse. So they went up and searched the land from the wilderness of Zin unto Rehob, as men come to Hamath. And they ascended by the south and came to Hebron, where Ahiman, Shishai, and Talmai, the children of Anak, were.
See, these tall cats. That's where Israel come with, say they come from the giants in the beginning. The children of Anak. Go ahead.
Now, Hebron was built 7 years before Zoan in Egypt. And they came unto the brook of Eshcol, and cut down from thence a branch with one cluster of grapes, and they bear it between two upon a staff.
So were those grapes small?
No.
Big. No. Huge. One cluster? And you got two brothers, you gotta carry these things? Or were these some grapes you gonna get in wraps on my yard to Value Plus? But $3.99. This is some real grapes, Jack. First ripe grape, that's what the timing was, right? So what that show you about our land? It was very fruitful.
Flourish.
It was flourished. It was a prosperous land. Filled with everything we would have need of. The land would just be fruitful. Go ahead.
It says, and they brought of the pomegranates and of the figs.
So did they get these dry stuff, pomegranates you see? You go get it at the grocery store, you think they came out with some? Or were these cold-blooded pomegranates?
That's real deal.
With figs, them figs is fruit. So these cats bringing back facts, right?
Facts.
Real produce. So this devil here be tricking us, man. Talking about Whole Foods, okay?
Okay.
Everything about a dollar with this guy, man. You see, we try to do the best we can do. But we see our land was prosperous. Go ahead.
24. The place was called the Brook of Eshcol.
Why?
because of the cluster of grapes which the children of Israel cut down from them. And they returned from searching of the land after 40 days.
Now, so 40 days, they would come back with facts. What did Moses tell them? Bring of the fruit thereof. And it just so happened to be the time of the first right fruits.
Right.
Or grapes. Go ahead.
26. Numbers 13, 26. And they went and came to Moses and to Aaron and to all the congregation of the children of Israel unto the wilderness of Paran to Kadesh, and brought back word unto them and unto all the congregation, and showed them the fruit of the land.
They came back. Look, Israel. Look at these figs. Look at these pomegranates. Look at these huge grapes. See that? So what was we like? That's out of sight. Wow.
We was in the wilderness.
Man. Look at that. See? Go ahead.
27. It says, and they told him and said, we came unto the land whither thou sentest us, and surely it floweth with milk and honey.
See, surely it floweth with milk and honey. You got bees there, cattle, flowers. It's very prosperous and fruitful and fertile. Right? That's why it was called the land of milk and honey, man. Go ahead.
And this is the fruit of it.
And this is the fruit of it.
Facts.
See? Now, watch this. Go ahead.
It says, Nevertheless,
go ahead.
The people be strong that dwell in the land, and the cities are walled and very great. And moreover, we saw the children of Anak there.
So here we go. But the people there are strong. They great. They tall. The walls are huge. What did we see the Most High do rolling with us?
Split the Red Sea.
Split the Red Sea. Drown a great power. That army of the Egyptians.
10 plagues.
Seeing the ten plagues. The Lord will bend show our nation how powerful he is. And now, people strong. The walls are high. We already seen we walked around Jericho 7 times and walls fell. That would happen, right? We didn't see it yet. But let's read on.
It says, 29, Numbers 13, 29. The Amalekites dwell in the land of the south, and the Hittites and the Jebusites and the Amorites dwell in the mountains. And the Canaanites dwell by the sea and by the coast of Jordan.
See, so now they say, and we're surrounded by the nations. Amorites, the Canaanites, Jebusites. They surround the place. We're surrounded by them. So what? So what are they pumping in Israel's ears?
Fear.
Now remember, 10 of these men are influential. All 12 are, but you got 10 that's coming with this report. So you think this was spread to Israel? Go ahead.
30th verse. And Caleb stilled the people before Moses had said, let us go up at once and possess it.
See that? Look at Caleb's spirit. Let's go! Right now! Why he's stealing the people? Because obviously the people are filled with negative spirits. Right? The congregation is negative. They move in a certain way. Caleb not. And that's what you will see in the body sometimes. The congregation be negative and we entertaining the negativity. And it's jumping. Them spirits, man. We have to cut it out. Bam, stop. Men murmuring, complaining, speaking evil. We entertaining the thing.
Right.
No. So what's happening? People about to fall away. See? This is what the Lord telling us, man. That we have to be gung-ho for the Lord. A lot of people be coming to be looking to take people out. We've got to be strong. Caleb, still in the people. Let's go. And take them out. What did he say? Let us go at once and possess it. Because who Caleb no role in with?
The Most High.
The Most High Christ. You see? He know. Continue.
It says, for we are well able to overcome it.
For we are what?
Well able to overcome it.
We well able to overcome it. Caleb double-minded?
Mm-mm.
That's faith.
Resolute.
We got the Lord with us. Israel in their mind, you got to see it. They're like, we're not well able to overcome it. Man, the nations are surrounding us. The report is, look, the children are not there, these giants. We gonna die. See that? This Israel will be today. You can't beat them, join them. Let's follow the nations. Yeah, out y'all mind, y'all think somebody gonna come out the sky to defeat the white man. What's wrong with y'all? Go ahead, brother.
Isn't there a law about that? You know, like when before you go out to war, just read it. Before you go out to war about a man who's fearful and also a man who just got married.
Right.
And I'm not sure that in Deuteronomy about how, you know, if you be fearful, that man should go to war because that spirit's gonna bounce around everybody else.
That's right. It's bigger than Deuteronomy 21. That's right. These spirits. A lot of our people don't think spirits be here. They be here jumping, moving.
And just on that point, like the brothers bringing out, you notice how many men went to go to the to go see the land?
40, I believe. 12.
Yeah, 12 men, right? Like the brother was bringing out through the spirit, you had 10 of them when they came back, they brought back a false report, but two of them brought back a different report.
Right.
So it's just showing you that we could be all seeing the same thing, but everybody else, we could all have different perceptions of things. See? And that deals with the spirit. Joshua and Caleb went over there and they saw the positivity. And the same thing that the Most High was seeing. But when the other 10 brought back the report, guess what? They had a whole different perception on how they were seeing. They saw the whole thing as negative. Go to Deuteronomy chapter 1 real quick. We'll go back here. And we'll continue. We're going to just, you know, we'll get Deuteronomy chapter 1, but we'll read up further on this as we continue to read Numbers. Deuteronomy 1. And verse 24. It says, and they turned and went up into the mount, and came unto the valley of Eshcol, and searched it out. And they took of the fruit of the land in their hands, and brought it down unto us, and brought word us again, and said, it is a good land which the Lord our God doth give us. See? So that was their perception of it. Like we read Numbers. It says, notwithstanding, would not go up, but what?
You rebelled.
You rebelled against the commandment of the Lord your God. See? It's bringing out this spirit. It says, and you murmured in what?
Your tents.
Your tents. See? When Israel went back, they was getting that word. When they went home, what were they doing?
Murmuring, speaking evil.
They were speaking evil, and that's what be happening. See? They had that negativity, and it was going on inside their houses and in their tents. It says, it said, because the Lord what? Hated us. He hath brought us forth out of the land of Egypt to deliver us into the hand of the Amorites and to destroy us. So when they went back to their tents, after the report was brought back, what were they speaking about in their homes?
How the Most High hated us.
See? Look, I told you, babe. Most High hated us. That's why he brought us over here. He's going to destroy us before the Amorites. This is how people, the negativity, when we don't have the spirit, this is how we think. It says, whether shall we go up? Our brethren have what? Discouraged our hearts, saying, the people is greater and taller than we, and the cities are great and walled up to heaven, and moreover up to the, and more, excuse me, walled up to the heaven. And moreover, we have seen the sons of the Anakims there. Then I said unto you, dread not, neither be ye afraid of them. It says, the Lord your God, which goeth before you, shall what? Fight for you, according to all that he did for you in Egypt before your eyes. See? So it's going right along with what's being brought out. Israel, we are people that's quick to forget. When we don't have a spirit, when we don't have that faith, we forget about all the things that the Most High has brought us through up until that point.
Forgetful of good turns.
Thank you. Forgetful of good turns. We quick to turn against the Most High because why? When we don't have a spirit, we automatically come with the negativity. We forget about how the Most High brought the plagues upon the Egyptians, how the Most High opened up the Red Sea, how the Most High drowned the Egyptians. Like the brothers bring it out. The Lord was bringing all that to fruition, saying, look how Israel's attitude and spirit is. We forget about the positive things the Most High has done for us in our lifetime, but the minute we experience some adversity, the first thing we quick to do is what? Blame the Most High and be quick to turn against his word. And that's what the people was being brought out. It's going to bring out why they was acting the way they was acting. Why they was murmuring and why they was speaking evil. See, we're going to get that in later chapters. And why Caleb and why Joshua had a whole different demeanor and perception about what was going on. So it's showing you, we could all be seeing the same thing, but have different points of view. And see, the whole thing totally different. So.
Right. And then you're here today, Israel will go home and say, God hate us, and say, brothers hate us. And that's what they were saying. See? Like you had today. They hate us. They be teaching the scriptures against us. They has hatred. That's love. Repent. So in Numbers 13, we continue in 30, our praises. So no, Moses gave us that recap.
Let me see. And just on that point, you know, because Israel will say they teach the scriptures against us. That's deliberately accusing somebody of targeting somebody with scriptures. And that's, when you read the scriptures, the scriptures go out, and the scriptures is against what?
Wickedness.
Wickedness. It's against the behavior. When Moses and Christ would bring out the scriptures, he never targeted the scribes and the Pharisees personally. What was he targeting?
The doctrine.
The doctrine and their behavior. So if the shoe fit, guess what? They had to wear. See, because Israel think you personally targeted me. No, if you're doing it, then we need to stop. That's like somebody saying, they ran a red light. You personally pulling me over. No, the law is you're not supposed to run a red light. Now, if you ran a red light, you get caught doing it, guess what? You're going to get a ticket. So it's not deliberately targeting people. Because people think that, oh, they're deliberately targeting me. No. The scriptures don't deliberately target anybody. That's what we got to understand. If you commit adultery, it says, thou shalt not commit adultery. Right?
Right.
Now, if the shoe fits, we commit adultery, guess what? It fits us. For the law was not made for a righteous man. Didn't Paul say that? But for the adulterer, for the murderer, for this, for that. See? That's why the law was to bring forth our sins. That's what we got to understand. If we fornicate, we got to stop fornicating. Never once do you read in the scriptures that Yahawashi personally called out Caiaphas or Annas or any of them wicked cats by name. He said the scribes and the Pharisees. Why? Because he wasn't targeting them personally. He was targeting their doctrine. Because in Matthew 23, what did Christ say? All that they what?
All that they.
All that they bid you.
That observe.
Thou observe, but what?
Not after their works.
Not after their works. We breaking the Sabbath day, that's on us.
Right.
Scripture say thou shalt not break the Sabbath day. If we break it, we buy it, we sell it, we doing all this and the other, then that's on us. It ain't on the scripture. Scripture's not supposed to say, all right, you know what? Since you offended at me telling, and me bringing up about the rules of the Sabbath, now Most High will erase, you know, all right, let's erase that fifth commandment. And now we only got nine. That's not what the scriptures is going to do. The scriptures is going to bring forth the scriptures, and the person that it applies to, we got to change. The Most High is not going to change his word for us. That's what we got to understand. And that's why Israel be getting upset at the Most High, because he ain't going to change. We the ones that got to change. See, if it's the doctrine is off, then we got to change the doctrine. If the doctrine ain't scriptural, then we got to change the scriptures. Hold your question.
No.
That's what we got to understand. Scriptures tell us to wear ribbon-blowing fringe. Most High ain't taking that out of Numbers. That's on us to apply that commandment. So just to bring that point out, you know, it ain't personally attacking nobody. If people are offended, Christ said, blessed are those that what? Are not offended in me. When the disciples of Christ left, why did they depart from Yahushua in John 6?
They
didn't believe and they were cut.
Christ said, the words I tell you, they offend you.
Thank you. So what were they offended at?
The word.
The word. That's what they got offended at. He said, and he said on purpose, does this offend you? Almost antagonizing. But we know Christ wouldn't do that. Does this offend you? Pew, they left. Adios. Then he turned right to his disciples and said, y'all leaving too? Because this show is going to keep moving.
That's why we're described as stiff-necked people.
That's right. We are hard-headed people. We don't like to listen. See, long as we doing the dog and pony show and letting it just go on as it will.
Let
bygones be bygones. Everybody can act however they want to act. We cool. Until somebody get punched in the face, then it's all. Well, nobody said nothing. Go ahead, Z.
No, like you said earlier when you spread out, I'm not sure where it's in the pocket, but it says, blessed the man with his conscience does not condemn him. In other words, if you get cut, that means you you examine yourself.
That's what we got to do.
That's it. Repent.
It ain't. See, Israel always, the problem was, Israel looked at the prophets. They wanted to kill the messenger.
Right.
See, never getting the message. Why would the Most High have to bring the messenger? Why would the Most High bring forth prophets? Why do they have to go speak to Israel?
To what? To warn us.
What'd you say?
To bring the message.
To bring the message, but why would he bring forth the prophets?
Because Israel was cutting up.
We was cutting up. That's why he brought the messenger. You rather deal with the messenger and his message than the Most High? That's the problem. Israel looking at the people. That brother, that sister, they always got something negative to say about me. That's a wicked spirit. See, and we don't want to deal with reality. We want to play games like we deal with the scriptures. We don't want to deal with the reality of the scriptures. And this is what Israel is dealing with here. They always had a problem with Moses. Moses didn't do nothing to him. See, so we just bring that point out. It's never the messenger, or it's never the person that's, you know, or they targeting me. We got other things to do with our lives besides target people. We got a lot more things in life to worry about than personally attacking somebody. We only feel attacked because it's the spirit of the scriptures that's bringing forth that message. And we got to change. That's all. We got to change. Most High ain't going to, he already put it plain and clear. I'm not changing. So the onus is on who?
Us
to change.
We got
to
be accountable.
We got to hold ourselves accountable. No accountability with the Most High. But then we want to ask the Most High for favors and for gifts and help me out, this, that, and the other. That's not going to work, man. Go ahead. Sorry.
No. Why do you pick my car out of all these cars, officer?
Right.
You ran the red light. Yeah, okay.
Keep playing.
Yeah. Numbers 13 and 30.
And Caleb stilled the people before Moses and said, "Let us go up at once and possess it, for we are well able to overcome it." But the men that went up with him said, "We be not able to go up against the people."
See that? Caleb coming with the right spirit. Here go the negative brothers. "No, we not. We ain't gonna." See, this is the one. You say green, they say red. You say black, they say pink.
Right.
Here it is. Those are the spirits you come across, Israel. What do you got right there? What do y'all see right there? What do you see?
Division.
Bingo. Right there. Right there. Negative spirits breed a division. There it is. But they Israel.
Mm-hmm. They know the Hebrew.
So now the people, you got Caleb and you got these other spies. And the congregation looking, whose side you think they're gonna jump on?
They cling to the negativity.
They gonna cling to the negativity. That's Israel. See? Continue.
"We be not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we."
See, the people stronger than us. Who we rolling with?
The Most High Christ.
The Most High Christ, the Almighty.
Godhead.
We'll say it, Almighty God. Yes. We say all powerful, almighty, and then guess what? We limit his power. See? Continue.
32. "And they brought up an evil report of the land which they had searched unto the children of Israel, saying, 'The land through which we have gone to search it is a land that eateth up the inhabitants thereof.'"
See, it's a land that's going to eat us up. The people going to destroy us. Pumping that fear in Israel. The Lord had already gave us the word. Israel didn't have the faith. We heard the gospel. This is all Hebrews 3, 4. See? The land that eats up people is going to eat us up. Go ahead.
"And all the people that we saw in it are men of great stature. And there we saw the giants, the sons of Anak, which come of the giants. And we were in our own sight as grasshoppers, and so we were in their sight."
See, we were like, compared to them, we like this. They huge. We like a small people to them. See? They discouraging the people. It's like your brother read in Deuteronomy. They're negative. See? They're rebelling. These are men, remember, these 10 spies, they were men of influence, right?
Right.
So you got 10 of them talking like this, brother.
10 to 2 of those spies.
See? Now you think we should be speaking against the scriptures?
No.
Being negative? No. Continue.
Numbers chapter 14, verse 1. "And all the congregation lifted up their voice and cried. And the people wept that night."
So what is Israel doing in their tents? Murmuring, crying. Oh God. Looking at their children. The Hebrew murder.
Damn, Moses and Aaron.
They're not just doing Israel. Listen, they're not just. This is a cry of anger. They're negative. They're in their houses, they tents, negative in their tabernacles. They got spirits on them. You don't just read this and they got their napkin and. It ain't going down like that, Israel. You know your people when they mad. They got spirits on them.
Ain't no more.
Spirits. Continue.
It said verse 2, and all the children of Israel murmured against Moses.
Against who?
Against Moses and against Aaron.
See that? So you think they just saying the Lord hate us? What are they talking about?
The messengers.
The messengers. Mm. Moses and Aaron. They boss out, they ain't no good, they evil. Telling they wives, they evil and this, do that happen?
Yeah. Amongst the body, absolutely.
And then that spread throughout the rest of the nation, right? Yeah, them brothers, they ain't, you see, they fooling you. They ain't no good, this, and that. Pissed off, look at the videos. They always talking about somebody's doctrine, this, and that. You know how we do. They ain't no good, they always this, and that. To hell with them, I'm gonna get my books.
They think they perfect.
They got it. Look at this, and that. Lord be like, uh-huh.
Keep talking.
Keep it up.
Your jealousy.
Keep it up, because the Most High hear it all. The Lord said when he sent Christ back, is in there, he gonna get all those that spoke them with them hard speeches against him.
Ungodly speech, idle words.
Every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give account of. What's the idle word? Evil speakings. That's what's happening here. This what did Paul tell the church in 1 Corinthians 10? Don't murmur. Why? Because Paul knows we're in that wilderness. Israel's cutting up. That's why we was talking like this earlier. Israel is cutting up right here. Lord set the thing up perfect. Send 12 spies to search the land and bring back the facts.
Agreed.
See? That fruit, he brought that fruit, and here we are talking, 10 of them. Now Israel is murmuring against Moses and Aaron. Those are not our leaders. Them ain't our elders, right? Go ahead.
And the whole congregation said unto them, would God that we had died in the land of Egypt, or would God we had died in this wilderness?
See that? How are they saying that? Look at
negative.
Look at this the point. What do you call that? Explanation point. Yeah.
They high.
They pissed off, brother. We wish we died in Egypt. Wish we died in this wilderness. They gonna have to give account of that. They talking. They ain't knowing. Lord hearing it all. Mm-hmm. So the scripture said in the apocrypha, beware of murmuring. These little groups and cliques. Okay. Go ahead.
It says, and wherefore hath the Lord brought us unto this land? To fall by the sword, that our wives and our children should be a prey?
See that? See how they looking at their families? Why did the Lord brought us in this wilderness? My baby boo, and my children will be a prey.
Bringing others into the family.
Looking at their families. See? Go ahead.
It say, were it not better for us to return into Egypt?
Look at that. It's better for us to go back to Egypt. Are they in the world?
Yes.
Worldly. They're worldly. That be our problem. That's why a lot of us can't come together, stick together, but we're worldly. We're carnal. And we scream Israel. And we want to be the first one to say, let's put our doctrines to the side. And then do what? Drink, barbecue, and talk about Edom. Con! Cognac, liquor, yayan, and say five words with a little Hebrew, and the rest is English and Spanish. That's us, with a bunch of books. See? And then talk smack. Come on, man. We be in the world. Just go with James 4 and 4. Now look, read on.
And they said one to another, let us make a captain and let us return to Egypt.
See, let us make us a captain. Ooh, a captain like them. That's karma.
World captain.
And let us return back to Egypt. So they want to do away with Aaron and Moses and them, right?
Right.
They didn't like them. Wanted to kill them. Then you read number 16. Here comes some more in the group. Korah, Dathan, Abiram, and all 250, they rise up. Lord was like, bring them out, bring them out, bring them out. See? Continue.
Then Moses and Aaron fell on their faces before all the assembly of the congregation of the children of Israel. And Joshua the son of Nun,
another good great brother, had a resolute spirit. Go ahead.
And Caleb the son of Jephunneh, which were of them that searched the land, rent their clothes.
See that?
They
don't want accord, them two. They ain't speaking evil against Moses and Aaron. They see what's going on. They see Israel cutting up. They rent, tearing their clothes. Go ahead.
It says, and they spake unto all the company of the children of Israel, saying, the land which we pass through to search it is an exceeding good land. If the Lord delight in us, then he will bring us into this land and give it us, a land which floweth with milk and honey. Only rebel not ye against the Lord, neither fear ye the people of the land, for they are bread for us.
See, the other 10 talking about the land. Joshua and Caleb like, no. The land ain't gonna eat us up. We gonna eat them up. Ain't that what they said? Mm-hmm. They be bread for us. We gonna consume them. We got the Lord on our side. It's a good land. Don't rebel, Israel. Now what type of spirit they have?
They got the spirit of the Most High Christ.
They got that spirit, man, of the Most High Christ, bro. They faithful. They know who they rolling with. They know their power. They ain't tripping like the rest of these Israelites are. See? They stand with it. No, we know what the word say. These brothers was resolute, man. Speaking the same word, right or wrong. See? They ain't been defiant, man. Lord love their spirit. Now, let's continue.
It says, only rebel ye not against the Lord, neither fear the people of the land, for they are bread for us. Their defense is departed from them, and the Lord is with us.
And the Lord is with us.
Fear them not.
Fear them not, Israel. Continue.
But all the congregation bade stone him with stones.
Look at that. And what did Israel, what they command? Stone him. They mad. See? All that was brewing that whole night. Can you see it?
The sun going down on them.
They mad. They ready to get rid of Moses, Aaron, Joshua, Caleb. Those that had the spirit, they ain't like it. See? They want to kill them, man. Continue.
It says, and the glory of the Lord appeared in the tabernacle of the congregation before all the children of Israel. And the Lord said unto Moses, how long will this people provoke me? And how long will it be ere they believe me for all the signs which I have showed among them?
See that? I showed them all my power, the signs, and they still don't believe. They don't have the faith. So who they attacking? The men of the faith. And that's what's going to happen in our nation. See? So this is spiritual. Go ahead.
I will smite them with the pestilence and disinherit them, and will make of thee a greater nation and mightier than they.
See, so the Lord had to tell Moses that many times. What we do in Exodus 32? Build a gold calf, party, rebel, get our freak on, singing. What is Israel ready to do tonight at 12 midnight? They already partying now, drunk. Getting tricked, going out to a devil, a god with two heads, Janus. Talking about some New Year's resolution. How is it the New Year and dead of winter? Our people's minds are gone. We was there. It'll be a bunch of fornication going on tonight. Cats wake up. What happened? You know what happened. You got that Remy in you and took Bob home and got AIDS. Now you're losing weight. Bob was waiting for you. You want to be in the club all night, tongue kissing and all this other foolishness. Right? Yeah,
there's fornication on many different levels. There's fornication in the flesh,
that's
fornication
right.
in the spiritual, fornicating against our God.
That's right. That's right. That's the most spiritual fornication, going after other gods, and that physical. See? We have men with men, women with women, ushering in some 2017. Okay. We're going to have to give account, Israel. See, the Most High is a God that's not to be tempted or played with. They talking, Israel talking right here, right?
Right.
They want to put their brothers to death. What the Lord tells in Exodus 20, thou shalt not murder. Did we forget that? Yep. Let's kill these men. We're the people that's quick to go off, like the brother said. We're a stiff-necked nation. See? Let's continue.
It says in the 13th verse.
Right.
It says, and Moses said unto the Lord, then the Egyptians shall hear it. For thou broughtest up this people in thy might from among them, and they will tell it to the inhabitants of this land. For they have heard that the Lord art among this people, that thou, Lord, art seen face to face, and that thy cloud standeth over them, and that thou goest before them by daytime in a pillar of a cloud, and in a pillar of fire by night.
See that? That's what we're talking about. So the nations knew that. Moses is like, look, we don't want the, Lord, you don't want the nation to start talking. They know you amongst us. See, we had the pillar, the cloudy pillar, Yahweh Shai with us, angels, everything, brother. We had it. But faithless. Faithless. See, being carnal. The Lord with us now as we speak. Let's continue.
It say, now, if thou shalt kill all this people as one man, then the nations which have heard the fame of thee will speak, saying, because the Lord was not able to bring this people into the land which he swore unto them, therefore ye have slain them in the wilderness.
See, so Moses didn't want the nations to say that. Go ahead.
And now, I beseech thee, let the power of my Lord be great according as thou hast spoken, saying, the Lord is long-suffering, and of great mercy, forgiving iniquity and transgression, and by no means clearing the guilty, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children, unto the third and fourth generation.
See, so Moses ain't making excuses for Israel's sin, but he's mediating. He's saying, Lord, I know you said it. If you're very merciful, you will bring judgment.
Right.
But Lord, be merciful to this people. Even though Israel being negative, they want to kill Moses, Aaron. This love right here. Joshua and Caleb. They for the people, even though the people were against them. And Moses being that mediator. Who was our mediator today? Yahweh Shai. See? So Moses ain't excusing their sin. Continue.
It say, 19th verse. Pardon, I beseech thee, the iniquity of this people according unto the greatness of thy mercy, and as thou hast forgiven this people from Egypt even until now. And the Lord said, I have pardoned according to thy word.
So the Lord said, all right, I'll pardon according to your word. Now watch this. So is he a God of mercy?
Yes.
Yes. Continue.
But as truly as I live, all the earth shall be filled with the glory of the Lord. Because all those men which have seen my glory and my miracles, which I did in Egypt and in the wilderness, and have tempted me now these 10 times, and have not hearkened to my voice, surely they shall not see the land which I swore unto their fathers. Neither shall any of them that provoke me see.
Look at that. But he a God of judgment also, right?
Yeah,
I pardon, but I'm getting them. That's a wrap for them. They want to play games and provoke me and tempt me. I'm getting them. That was like group 20 and up. So that's why we went to Ecclesiastes 16. As his mercy is great, so is his wrath. You see? And we're going to read. We're going to see. All that talking. Lord said, I'm dealing with them.
Just a point about the Most High's forgiveness. Like it was brought out through the Spirit, all praises. The Lord does forgive. But like the brother was bringing out and the scriptures brought out, even though we've forgiven for our sins, there's still a judgment, see? And that's how the Most High gets down. The pardon was what? Most High didn't put Israel to death.
At that time,
see? He could have judged them right there on the spot and killed them. But it doesn't mean just because they was pardoned, there wasn't a repercussion for that. And there's another example, bring this up real quick, about David. 2 Samuel chapter 12. I'll read it. It says, 2 Samuel chapter 12 and verse 9. About how the Most High forgive, but he's not going to just let it just go that easily. It says, wherefore thou didst despise the commandment of the Lord to do evil in his sight? Thou hast killed Uriah the Hittite with the sword, and hast taken his wife to be thy wife, and hast slain him with the sword of the children of Ammon. Now therefore the sword shall never depart from thine house, because thou didst despise me, and hast taken the wife of Uriah the Hittite to be thy wife. Thus saith the Lord, behold, I will raise up evil against thee out of thy own house. It says, and will take away thy wives before thy eyes, and give them unto thy neighbor, and he shall lie with thy wives in the sight of the sun. It says, for thou didst it secretly, but I will do this thing before all Israel and before the sun. And David said unto Nathan, I have sinned against the Lord. And Nathan said unto David, the Lord hath put away thy sin. Thou shalt not what? Die. See? Most High put away his sin, but he spared David's what?
Life.
He spared his life. Howbeit, because by this deed thou hast given great occasion to the enemies of the Lord to blaspheme, the child also that is born unto thee shall surely die. See? And Nathan departed unto the house, and the Lord struck the child that Uriah's wife bare unto David, and it was very sick. And then you read later on, the child eventually ended up dying. But because David's sin was pardoned, he didn't die. That means the rest of David's life was filled with what?
Turmoil.
Sorrow. Same thing the Most High did here with Israel. He'll forgive us, but it don't mean that the Most High is just going to just totally let this thing go. That's like, for example, a guy who repented Christ and committed murder. You've been given, two life sentences. Just because you repent, the Most High will have forgiveness upon us, but guess what?
You still got to do the time.
You still going to do the 2 life sentences. That ain't, jails ain't going to just open up because we repent in the name of the Lord. That's reality. So Israel, even though the Most High didn't destroy him at that time, Most High still has something else coming for him.
Yeah, because you gotta understand, he already, they're not going to the land. Mm. He's talking about pardoning the ones under, they gonna get the land. Under 20, this group is done. He just told us. In the 23rd verse, what did he say? Surely, surely they shall not see the land. That's a wrap. So that pardon, listen, this other group of Israelites, they going. He gonna keep his promise for them to get the land. This group, that wasn't forgiven, was it forgiven? No. It just told us.
Right.
They not going to the land. You see?
Right.
He says, surely they shall not see the land which I swear unto their fathers, neither shall any of them that provoke me see it. So what was going to happen to them?
They was going to eventually die.
They're going to die. Where?
In the wilderness.
That's a wrap. He's a God of judgment. Just like Esau despised his birthright, and that was a wrap. That's what Paul telling us. He used Esau for that example in Hebrew. Don't be like Esau, fornicating. Because when he would inherit the blessing, it was too late, though he sought it with tears. It's a wrap. Once Christ come back, we got to repent now. It's a wrap. That's why I said the Lord ain't going to send Christ turning back around. Now's the time of repentance. Not Christ come, get us, take us to the wilderness.
No, come on, Israel.
That's some man-made devil doctrine. That's for you to continue in your sins. All Israel gonna be saved, we're gonna have you and birth you in the kingdom. What scripture is that?
No scripture.
No scripture. So continue in your sin, but you'll still get the kingdom. That's gonna get you destroyed, Israel. That's why we be on these doctrines. These doctrines be messing people's lives up. Because some man is set in his room and say, you know what? I can get paid off this thing. Let me spin a scripture and get some more scriptures and scream tally-hooty. Y'all see that in the scripture? It's over. That's what he said. So we have to pay attention to what we're reading. Now verse 24, look what he say. 24, go with 23.
But my servant, Caleb, because he had another spirit with him and hath followed me fully, him will I bring into the land whereinto he went, and his seed shall possess.
See that? But Caleb, Joshua, in that group of 20 and above, they would make it. That was it. Those two. Why? They had the right spirit. Look how they were talking. 20 and up. They taught us that in the scriptures. Those 20 and up. We read that Numbers 1. They wouldn't make it. Only Joshua and Caleb. Moses, and then he couldn't even get in the land, man. This should be sobering. Like, man. Is the Lord a God of judgment?
Yes.
Yeah. That's why we be doing things and thinking nothing happening to us. We roll on one another. It must be cool. It's not. Because when the Lord say, deal with this brother now, deal with this sister, it's a wrap. I'm sick and tired of it. That's it. That's why we gotta walk in fear, man. Israel be too loosey-goosey. That's in our homes. Loose. Be patient with the wife. Look, teach the fear of the Lord in the house. It ain't no game, man. This is no game. Israel think this is a game to play. Get knowledge. Knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. Live how you wanna live, though. We Israel. See? Caleb had another spirit. Men of the faith, right? They didn't see the miracles just like that other, the mother brothers, sisters. They believed, brother. Now, would Caleb and Joshua be rewarded?
Yeah.
Thank you. That's why we started Hebrews 11 and 6. That's how they felt, brother. They diligently sought the Lord, and they would get rewarded. Will they be rewarded again? Yes. The kingdom of heaven, brother. Them brothers knew, man, about Yahweh Shai. They knew that that land was temporary. See? They knew. These other Israelites is carnal. Cutting up, tripping. Lord said, I got their ticket. That's why we read in Ecclesiastes 16. That 600,000 foot men and all that, they got, the Lord showed them mercy. It told us that. And it's telling us here. But the Lord will allow these other Israelites in the land, 20 and under. It was a wrath. Verse 25, let's read it.
Now the Amalekites and the Canaanites dwell in the valley. Tomorrow, turn you and get you out into the wilderness by the way of the Red Sea.
Turn around. Go ahead.
And the Lord spake unto Moses and unto Aaron, saying, how long shall I bear with this evil congregation, which murmur against me? I have heard the murmurings of the children of Israel, which they murmur against me. Say unto them, as truly as I live, saith the Lord, as ye have spoken in my ears, so will I do to you.
Look at that. Would they have to give an account for their words?
Gotta be held accountable.
Say, I got it. Tell them, Moses. Tell them what I just told you. So what Moses got to go do now? Give them what?
The message.
Bad news. The message. Can you imagine that?
They already got spirits on
them. They already got spirits. Now Moses got to go tell them. You ain't making it. That's cold. That's cold.
Not really, because they bought on themselves.
Yeah, I'm saying when I say it's cold, mean cold-blooded. Cold-blooded. Yeah, I mean, yeah, like that's cold-blooded. Not, that's a cold thing. Like, not that way.
Like, it's not harsh.
Like harsh, yeah. That's just the Detroit thing on slang, my brother. I know what you're saying, though. Yeah, that's not, Moses gotta come tell him. Go ahead.
It says, your carcasses shall fall in this wilderness, and all that were numbered of you, according to your whole number, from 20 years old and upward, which have murmured against thee.
Oh, murmuring ain't nothing. It's okay to murmur. We ain't doing nothing wrong. Yeah, okay. That was a wrap, brothers. See? Go ahead.
Doubtless, ye shall not come into the land.
Now you see why Hebrews 3 and 4 is cold-blooded. Paul warned the church, don't have an evil heart of unbelief to depart from the living God, and he started going into this.
He knows the scripture.
You know that mystery, man. He knows the scriptures. Continue.
It says, doubtless, ye shall not come into the land concerned, which I swear to make you dwell therein, save Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, and Joshua, the son of Nun. Mm. But your little ones, which he said should be a prey.
The ones you said it should be a prey in your tents, Israel. Go ahead.
Them will I bring in. Mm. And they shall know the land which ye have despised.
Which you have what?
Despised.
Despised.
Hey.
Would they despise the inheritance? Yes, that's why I said Paul brought out Esau. How Esau despised his birthright. And then once that went down, it was a wrap. It was too late. he wasn't getting the kingdom. You see? So that's sobering. So now Moses got to tell him, look, y'all 20 and up, you're going to die. But your children, they getting the land. See? You talking about they going to be a prey? No. Your carcass is going to be in this wilderness. Go ahead.
It says, but as for you, your carcasses, they shall fall in this wilderness, and your children shall wander in the wilderness 40 years and bear your whoredoms.
And bear your what?
Whoredoms.
Like my brother was bringing out. What was Israel doing going after other gods? That's why the Lord says whoredoms. Now the children got to sit there in the woods looking at their dad and all this. All because of you. We got to go on to this wilderness. 40 years. They got to catch hell. See that?
And you know they would get reminded of it because that's what we read in Deuteronomy 1, the repeat. So this generation had to be reminded
right.
that they wouldn't have a heart like their fathers had.
That's right.
Well, that's why y'all was in this wilderness. So we going to talk about stuff constantly so we can not fall to the same temptations as brothers and sisters that left. Or even in this case, in the wilderness, they had to be reminded so they wouldn't have the same fate of their forefathers.
That's right. That's what all these are written for our learning. Not to be attacked. No, this is for our learning. So we can make it. We don't want to be like our foremothers and forefathers right here that was evil and being carnal. So it's saying your children shall wander in the wilderness 40 years and bear your whoredoms. Go ahead.
It says, until your carcasses be wasted in the wilderness. Mm-hmm. After the number of the days in which ye search the land, even 40 days, each day for a year,
each day for a year,
shall ye bear your iniquities, even 40 years, and ye shall know my breach of promise.
And ye shall know my what? Breach of promise. Because he was going to bring the mother ones in by promise. But there was a breach there for them. And they going to die. They ain't getting the land. See, that was it. You think God would reverse it? No. He said, doubtless. See how the Lord is? When it's a wrap, it's a wrap. He be giving us time and time and time again. Change, change, classes go out. Go out, go out. I don't want to change. They go out, they go out. Then wham! And the Lord be having more and more for us. Go ahead, brother.
It say, 35th verse. I, the Lord, have said, I will surely do it unto all this evil congregation that are gathered together against me. In this wilderness they shall be consumed, and there they shall die.
But they didn't have the faith, man. Go ahead.
It says, and the men which Moses sent to search the land, who returned and made all the congregation to murmur against him by bringing up a slander upon the land, even those men that did bring up the evil report upon the land died by the plague before the Lord.
Look at that. What happened to them 10?
They got hit with a plague.
Bam! Right, right before Israel, right there. Plagued up, brother. Diseased up. See? So I said, we just read it. Just keep reading. There ain't no mystery. He's merciful, but he will bring judgment. That's what we'll show our children. Go ahead, my brother.
Yeah, 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 10 says, neither murmur ye, as some of them also murmured, and were destroyed of the destroyer. Mm-hmm. Now all these things happen unto them for examples, and they are written for our admonition, mm-hmm. upon whom the ends of the earth are come.
Cold. cold. So anybody say, well, y'all reading in Numbers, the Old Testament. We're all taking the church back to Numbers.
Right.
Beautiful precept. See, and you have that in Israel. Jews spoke about these are murmurers, complainers, having not the spirit, who separate themselves. Who's right, who's wrong? What are they doing, Israel? By their fruits you shall know them. Quit being colorblind. I don't want to see it. It's happening before our eyes. Wake up.
Wake up.
This is real. It's happening. Is it a dream? It's happening. See? So this is cold. Lord wasn't playing with them, man. Verse 38.
But Joshua the son of Nun and Caleb the son of Jephunneh, which were of the men that went to search the land, lived still.
They kept on moving. Like the brothers say, did the program keep going on?
Yep.
Lord knew, I got some more Israelites at the next stop. By the way, I hear 250 plotting right along with these other famous men in the congregation. I got some for them too. And another group that's going to complain and murmur after they go, after I swallow them up by the earth, I got some for them too. So, what group we want to be? This is written for our admonition, our learning, our warning. Don't do it, Israel. See? And here we want to be right in line in the fire. How you go? You see fire burning up people. Let me get in that line. What's wrong with us? I like that fire. That's a friendly fire.
It looks pretty.
That's us, man. Man, where is this at? Continue.
It says, and Moses told these things unto all the children of Israel, and the people mourned greatly.
See that? Moses told them, y'all gonna die. You ain't going in the land.
He couldn't sugarcoat it.
And all they could do, wrath. You imagine that? We're gonna die here. We ain't going. You see that? The brother get a message, he like, damn. Watch their spirit. This is this group. Read on.
And they rose up early in the morning and gave them up into the top of the mountain, saying, lo, we be here. And we'll go up to the place which the Lord hath promised. For we have sinned.
It's too late. What did the Lord say?
You're not going.
You're not going. Where we are? No, you're not. It's a wrap. There's a price to pay. We're here. They should have been like that earlier.
From the jump.
Yeah. Go ahead, brother.
That's why you watch the first 48 and the guy to do the murder. He get caught. They got all alone. And now he start crying. And they say, would you cry when you pull that trigger on him?
Mm-mm.
Should have been crying when you shoot that brother. Now you got 25
to life. That's it. Go in that courtroom judge, say, give him life. Kicking it with that one brother. Oh my God! Yeah, you thought you was getting camp. 6 months. No. You getting a hockey number.
No!
That gravel hit. Bam! Get him out of my courtroom. See? When the judgment time, it ain't no. Yeah, we partying. When Christ come back and say, then the tribes go more. They don't be like, yay, yee yak jack. They gonna know who it is. They gonna know. Ain't no polite all them, yeah, because no, ain't no Crips, Blood, Crip walking, none of it's a rap. Repentance went out. See? Let the ball drop to the casket drop, man. It's just a rap, man. All that talking. See? My pastor said, it's a rap, man. That's what we reading. And they trying to get in. We sin. Hebrews 12. Go ahead.
And Moses said, wherefore now do you you transgress the commandment of the Lord, but it shall not prosper.
See? See what they're about? Doing their own thing, right?
Presumptuous.
They presumptuous. Y'all still about breaking God's commandment. He told you ain't going. You still want to do our thing. That's how they work the whole time. Let's do our thing. Let us make us a captain. Stone them.
They didn't see.
Mm-hmm. They didn't see this coming. Go ahead.
Go not up, for the Lord is not above you, that ye be not smitten before your enemies. For the Amalekites and the Canaanites are there before you, and ye shall fall by the sword, because ye are turned away from the Lord. Therefore the Lord will not be with you. But they presume.
But they what?
They presume.
What type of spirit did they have?
Self-will.
Self-will. Presumptuous. They would do their own thing. Don't Peter and Jude talk about this? This type of group? See? But they presume. That's a bold group of people right here. We still gonna go up. Go ahead.
But they presume to go up unto the hilltop. Nevertheless, the ark of the covenant of the Lord and Moses departed not out of the camp. Then the Amalekites came down, and the Canaanites was dwelt in that hill, and smote them, and discomfited them, even unto Hormah.
Then they just died, brother. Lord, get more of them. Go to Numbers 32. You see that?
Numbers chapter 32, verse 1. Now the children of Reuben and the children of Gad had a very great multitude of cattle. And when they saw the land of Jazer and the land of Gilead, that behold, the place was a place for cattle.
So you got right here the tribes, you got Reuben and Gad. They like, okay, because this was part of their inheritance. They like, this is a place for cattle. Yeah. Go ahead.
They say, the children of Gad and the children of Reuben came and spake unto Moses and to Eleazar the priest, and unto the princes of the congregation, saying, Ataroth and Dibon and Jazer and Nimrod and Heshbon and Eliab and Shebah and Nebo and Beor, even the country which the Lord smote before the congregation of Israel is a land for cattle. And thy servants have cattle. Wherefore said they, if we have found grace in thy sight, let this land be given unto thy servants for a possession, and bring us not over Jordan.
See? Don't bring us over Jordan. That's what other tribe, they land would be. East of Jordan, right? Or on the other side of Jordan. And Moses, where he could just see that land. So what is Gad and Reuben thinking about?
They
about themselves. See? Right here is about them.
We got our piece of the pie.
Hey, place for cattle. See, they not thinking right. Go ahead.
And Moses said unto the children of Gad and to the children of Reuben, shall your brethren go to war and shall ye sit here?
See what Moses had to tell them? Because we was going to take out the Canaanites and all that. We would, the other tribe would have to go to war. So y'all want to chill? We gonna let your brothers go in battle? Is that thinking right?
No.
So what did Moses do to them? He corrected them. Because they would be about themselves. Go ahead.
And wherefore discourage ye the heart of the children of Israel from going over into the land which the Lord had given them.
See that? So by them being selfish, what would that have the other tribes of the spirit? They would take upon them, be discouraged. My brothers ain't going.
They would want to go continue the mission.
The fight.
They would want to continue to fight.
See that? Now you think the Lord want Israel to be discouraged?
No.
What happened in Numbers 14? Israel got discouraged because of those 10 spies.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
It says, and wherefore discourage ye the heart of the children of Israel from going over into the land which the Lord hath given them. Thus did your fathers.
Thus did your fathers. This is the same thing that the 10 spies did. Go ahead.
When I sent them from Kadesh Barnea to see the land. For when they went up into the valley of Eshcol and saw the land, they discouraged the heart of the children of Israel, that they should not go into the land which the Lord had given them. And the Lord's anger was kindled the same time, and he sware, saying, surely none of the men that came up out of Egypt from 20 years old and upward shall see the land which I swore unto Abraham, unto Isaac, and unto Jacob, because they have not wholly followed me.
Because they didn't wholly follow me. They didn't have faith. Go ahead.
Save Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, the Kenizzite, and Joshua, the son of Nun. For they had wholly followed the Lord.
See that? Go ahead.
And the Lord's anger was kindled against Israel, and he made them wander in the wilderness 40 years until all the generation that had done evil in the sight of the Lord was consumed.
See? So like your brother was bringing out, this what had to be that he talked about. Because he had Gad and Reuben had that spirit. About they self and discouraging other tribes. Go ahead.
It says, and behold, ye are risen up in your father's stead, an increase of sinful men.
What did Moses call them? An increase of sinful men. He corrected them. Go ahead.
To augment yet the fierce anger of the Lord toward Israel.
See, you gonna bring wrath again on Israel for having this spirit. Those should we be selfish? Everything about us. Then we discouraging others, quenching the spirit. We supposed to be quenching each other's spirit?
No.
Exhorting. We supposed to be exhorting, man. Helping out. If you can't help, don't. If you can help, help. You don't help and look for something in return.
Right.
I'm gonna do this so I can expect something in return. Don't, come on, man. What type of charity is that? Then bring it up back in somebody's face. Then nobody want to deal with you getting nothing from you. Here, man, I'm broke. Here, Anya, here's 20. I'm broke. Well, you broke. Why give me $20, man? You ain't got it, you give it. That's because then in the next 3 hours, you looking for that 20 again. I'm hungry. Can I get that 20 back? I give you half, but I need to get some chicken. Jacking cats up, man. Let's continue.
It says 15 verse. If ye turn away from after him, he will yet again leave them in the wilderness, and ye shall destroy all his people. And they came near unto him and said, we will build sheepfolds here for our cattle and cities for our little ones. But we ourselves will go ready armed before the children of Israel until we have brought them unto their place. And our little ones shall dwell in the fenced cities because of the inhabitants of the land. We will not return unto our houses until the children of Israel have inherited every man his inheritance.
See that? So they got set straight by Moses. That was the correction. They received it. That's right. He had to do it. Moses had to do what he had to do, man. They didn't. I can't stand it.
No way.
Be pissed off. You always, Moses always bothering us. They like, that's right. You know what? We're gonna go assist the rest of the tribes, our brothers. That's right. They got set straight. All praises. Go ahead.
For we will not inherit with them on yonder side Jordan or forward, because our inheritance is fallen to us on this side Jordan eastward. And Moses said unto them, if ye will do this thing, if ye will go armed before the Lord to war, and will go all of you armed over Jordan before the Lord, until he have driven out his enemies from before him, and the land be subdued before the Lord, then afterward ye shall return and be guiltless before the Lord.
See?
And before Israel.
See, you'll be blameless before the Lord and the rest of your people, your brothers and sisters, because you're looking out for others instead of yourself.
They wouldn't have the charity at this time.
Right. So all we need to know to get ourselves right with the Lord is in the scriptures. This is what we're going to be judged off of, Israel. The Bible. The doctrine of Christ. Not that we know the Hebrew. The vows and all this other stuff. We didn't know what tribe it was from. Okay. Continue.
It says, and this land shall be your possession before the Lord. But if you will not do so, behold, ye have sinned against the Lord. And be sure your sin will find you out.
Ain't that cold-blooded? Powerful. What do you mean by, you know, sin will find you out? They be in there partying with their cattle. Land, Israel fighting. What do you think will happen eventually?
Eventually, judgment.
Judgment will come. That evil will find its way.
Evil pursueth sin.
That's right. That's why Israel going out there partying, doing their thing. It's going to catch up to them. See? Moses warned them, your sin shall find you out. Meaning, the evil gonna come. If y'all do what you say, y'all stay in that land and do your own thing. Help your brothers. If you don't, that evil gonna, your sin gonna find you out. It's all praises. Now go to Joshua. It's Joshua 14. Six. And now we're doing the time of Joshua. So we would get the land under Joshua. All praises. What happened to the mother and group of Israelites? They got consumed in the wilderness talking. It's just sobering.
Joshua 14, verse 6. Then the children of Judah came unto Joshua in Gilgal. And Caleb the son of Jephunneh of the Kenizzite said unto him, thou knowest the thing that the Lord had said unto Moses the man of God concerning me and thee in Kadesh Barnea. 40 years old was I when Moses the servant of the Lord sent me from Kadesh Barnea to spy out the land.
So Caleb was 40 years old when he went to spy out the land, brother. Go ahead.
And I brought him word again. As it was in my heart.
As it was in my heart, in my spirit. This is what the deal is, Moses. And what was he telling Israel? We can take it.
Right. Let us go up.
The Lord is with us. They bread for us. That was all in his spirit, brother. Go ahead.
It says, Nevertheless, my brethren that went up with me made the heart of the people melt.
Melt. Meaning those other 10 made Israel heart weak. They quenched the spirit, didn't they? Mm-hmm. They quenched Israel's spirit. That's why the scriptures say, quench not the spirit. Despise not prophesying. We do that. Go ahead.
But I wholly followed the Lord my power. And Moses swore on that day, saying, surely the land whereon thy feet have trodden shall be thine inheritance. And thy children's forever, because thou hast wholly followed the Lord my power. And now behold, the Most High hath kept me alive, and he has said, these 45 years, even since the Lord spake this word unto Moses, while the children of Israel wandered in the wilderness, and now lo, I am this day 85 years
so
old.
How old was Caleb?
85.
85 years old, brother. He's seen it all go down. He made it. At 85, he said, I'm 85 years old. Go ahead.
And say, as yet I am as strong this day, I was in the day that Moses sent me.
And yet I am as strong this day as I was in the day that Moses sent me. So the strength he had at 40, he had at 85. No, he'd be 85, would be not him. This brother was vibrant, an 85-year-old vibrant brother. Still ready. Go ahead.
It said, even so is my strength now for war, both to go out and to come in.
Ain't that cold?
Now therefore,
what was he saying?
I can still go to war.
I can still go to war and fight. I can still do this thing, man. At 85. He talking about the war, brother. Let's do this. Think about that. You look at next time you look at somebody 85, brother. Who gave him that strength?
The Most High.
So do we reward those that diligently seek him and have faith? See? Go ahead.
And say, now therefore, give me this mountain whereof the Lord spake in that day, for thou heardest in that day how the Anakims were there, and that the fenced cities were great and fenced. And so be the Lord will be with me, then I shall be able to drive them out, as the Lord said. And Joshua blessed him and gave Caleb the son of Jephunneh Hebron for an inheritance.
See, he got Hebron. Cities, land, earth, city, the city Hebron, that's yours. We think when Christ comes back, we endure. Be rewarded with greatness, brother. World, everything that exists. Can't even think about it. See? Rewarded. Kept the faith, kept the, you fought the good fight. Go ahead.
Verse 14 says, Hebron therefore became the inheritance of Caleb, the son of Jephunneh the Kenizzite, unto this day.
Why?
Because that he wholly followed the Lord power of Israel.
Did he get rewarded for his faith? Mm-hmm. That's why he got the city Hebron. Then he had a daughter, married her off, and then she was asking for blessings. He was like, give me this spring. Yep, you can have the spring water. What else you want? The upper and the nether part. Getting rewarded, brother. There wasn't no paper money. We on the paper chase. We got to get this dollar, dog. We want the earth. See, he saw me tricking us. You gonna get your wings. Sit on some clouds. Ain't gonna sit on mist, Israel. Vapor. Sit on some vapor right there. This dude give us all type of garbage, brother. We run around and believe it. Rudolph and Cupid and all that flying through the air. He told us reindeers fly. And we get a garbage to our children. Put them to sleep early, work hard all year, and then tell them a white man and giving them presents. Knowing you didn't work overtime, broke your back. You got the children putting out cookies and milk. Looking through a JCPenney catalog in the back, toy section. Write that for Santa, what you want? 10 things. G.I. Joe. On this racetrack. Remember when you was a child going through the JCPenney catalog, writing a note to Santa. Dear Santa, out of our mind.
You been eating while I'm mental ward, man.
Our parents and grandparents taught us to fear fake as Santa more than the Lord.
Right, man. Right. And we say the real Santa is Crump is a devil. He was to make the people come and be killing people. And that's what they sing that song. He knows when you are asleep, like Freddy Krueger, because he was a demon. Now it's flipped in America. It's a good thing. Better watch out. You better not. I see.
I'm telling you.
Wow. Yeah, it just flipped, brother. You see? So this dude, this man Esau is no joke. He killing us as we speak. With the water, I got that docu-show.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Putting all type of mercury and all this fluoride and all type of stuff.
Making you sterile.
See? You going to get the, what they do for cancer? Radiation?
Chemo.
That really killed you. How you gonna break down a man person's immune system? That's the first line of defense. You take herbs and to build your immune system. No, that's destroyed. You know how much money they make off cancer?
Billions.
You don't even have it there till you have it. You know you got cancer. It's a wart. You all scared now? They give me the key now. You're getting all jacked up, man. So they geared, man. Them hospitals geared to destroy us, brother. We ain't saying don't go. You gotta go. You gotta go. But this man ain't no joke. He a killer. He a killer. The Lord got his ticket. So from there, let's go to Ecclesiastes. All praises.
You know, this stuff, you know, we understand when people go on rest, they're asleep.
Right.
But you talk to Israel, that's my mama better. First thing they do, I know you're living there, man. Like, you come on, really? That's how I was thinking.
Yeah.
You know, you're up there. And you sleep. He's
sleep. Right.
Knowing our minds and them are mad potatoes.
Yep. Yeah, because he pumped fear in us, and he pumped us to fear death and all that stuff. Well, the Lord teaches us about the resurrection. We live to live again, man. That's beauty. People fall asleep, they ain't gotta go through the pain. That stuff be like, bam! But this man make movies about death and start instill the fear in us. Start teaching us about people burning underground. I mean, come on, brother. Hades and all this. You walking on the earth, people burning down there. As a child, where the hell at? Where's the devil? Where's Damien at? Right there. That bad child right there, Damien. With a knife at you over your head while you sleep. Right? We thinking the devil underground. Burning people with a pitchfork. A trident fork. Yeah. Dante's Inferno. They be lying. Lying. Rabbits lay eggs.
Straight up.
Lying. Angels are babies with diapers on, with curly hair. Cupid. Lying. Women angels. Lying. We believe the thing. We believe everything this man give us, we believe. We come out from churches destroyed, thinking we up. You see? And a lot of these Israelite groups be lying and they holding on to Esau stuff, brothers. That Yiddish, the little customs they going to, they be having that Tanakh all up in there trying to bring out wisdom. They ain't getting it, man. The Talmud, they got that. Lexicon, all this other stuff to break down words. I'm gonna get a better understanding. Just read and repent. Scriptures say in Psalms 111, a good understanding have all they that keep his commandments, not that read the Hebrew. If thou desire wisdom, keep the commandments, and the Lord shall give her unto thee. That's it. Go ahead, my brother.
Speaking on death, in Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 3, verse 2, it says, in the sight of the unwise, they seem to die, and their departure is taken for misery, and their going from us to be utter destruction, but they are at peace. Mm. And then the precept for that is also in Ecclesiastes chapter 22, verse 11 and 12, which says, weep for the dead, for he had lost the life, and weep for the fool, for he wanted understanding. Make little weeping for the dead, for he is at rest. Mm. But the life of a fool is worse than death. 7 days do men mourn for him that is dead, but for a fool and an ungodly man, all the days of his life.
That's right.
And that's what the world teaches us in those last two sentences right there.
That's right. That's right. God's presence.
Oh, Psalm, what is it?
No, it's Ecclesiastes.
I know, but what you quote about the wise, but the man about learning about Hebrew.
Psalm 111. Psalm 111.
And what?
And 10.
10. I think it's, yeah, 10.
Psalm 111.
Okay, yeah.
You got it?
Yeah.
Right. What it say?
So the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
Mm.
And good understanding have all they that do his commandments. His praise endure forever.
It's all praises. That's it. That's it. And you like the brother brought out, you look at a fool like, look, he ain't at rest, he getting jacked up because he a fool. One is there at rest, brother. They ain't underground burning like this man teach. Nah, the destruction coming at Christ's second coming on this earth, not under the ground. So this man then taught us a bunch of lies, and look what he got us doing as we speak. Waiting for the ball to drop.
Shitlin.
See? Drunk watching the game, and wait, yeah, chitlin night, man. Black eyed peas, greens, and chitlins. You wanna call it chitterlings, I have it, it's pork, swine, and sting. So this is Ecclesiasticus 46:1. I'll read it, thank you, brother. All praises. Say, Jesus is talking about Joshua, so it's a translation. The son of Nun, Nay, was violent or valiant in the wars and was the successor of Moses in prophecies, who according to his name was made great for the saving of the elect of God. See that? So it was Joshua who got that elect group of Israelites to enter into the land. We were under Joshua, because remember, oh, Israel ain't come out that wilderness, Jack. So an elect group made it right under Joshua. And when it came to war, Joshua was a bad brother in Israel. Straight up. The Lord was with him. Why? Because he was in and out of them scriptures, was he not? That's Joshua 1:8. It says, and taking vengeance of the enemies that rose up against them, that he might set Israel in their inheritance. How great glory got he when he did lift up his hands and stretch out his sword against the what? Cities. So Joshua's going through cities going to work on them nations, them Hamites. The hell with Egyptology. Joshua was going to work, Jack.
Work.
A warrior. Verse 3, who before him stood to it, for the Lord himself brought his enemies unto him. See, the Lord was bringing this Joshua enemies right before him. And Joshua was tearing their butt up. That's right, Yahushua. Did not the sun go back by his means, and was not one day as long as two? Remember that? Joshua prayed, Lord, stop the sun and the moon. Let me get these Hamites. Tear they stinking butt up. They need more dark. The Lord said, all right. You listen to Joshua's prayer, man, and answer it. He called upon the Most High Lord when the enemies pressed upon him on every side. And the great Lord heard him. And with hailstones of mighty power, he made the battle to fall violently upon the nations. And in the descent of Bethoron, he destroyed them that resisted, that the nations might know all their strength, because he fought in the sight of the Lord, and he followed the Mighty One. That's the Spirit. In the time of Moses, also he did a work of mercy. He and Caleb, we read this, the son of Jephthah, and that they withstood the congregation, and we withheld the people from sin and appeased the wicked murmuring. See that? What the Lord called murmuring? Wickedness. Here you go, verse 8. And of 600,000 people on foot, they too were preserved to bring them into the heritage. So what is our inheritance? The land called also heritage. Israel going to Jeremiah 17. Thou shalt discontinue from thy inheritance. See, that's why you don't know who you are. It's talking about our land. The Lord will take away our land.
Gotcha.
promise. Not your nationality. There's other scriptures for that. And we're going breaking stuff down wrong.
The Jews are black. We're not the black Hebrew Israelites. Give me Jeremiah 14 and 2. Read. Black unto the ground. What? Black unto the ground. See? The call of the Israelite.
He just said we're not black Hebrew Israelites. Make up your mind. And that scripture ain't talking about that. We on the streets, man. Esau laughing at us. Let's give him some glory. Let's go send some media down there and talk. Hey, we on TV. Look, there we go, out in the streets.
Come.
Hey, the magazine came down and interviewed us. We're somebody. This is our 13th church we built. We're breaking ground. That is a carnal movement, Israel. Christ has given us the kingdom. See, what these brothers is doing, they going out there doing their own thing. The kingdom of heaven is within you. That means you gotta usher this thing in. The Lord is waiting for you, Israel, to usher it in. Get out there and do something. That's gonna get you killed. So now, whose seat are we trying to take?
Christ's seat. The Lord told him, sit down at my right until I make thine enemies.
Thank you. But we ain't supposed to wait on Christ. Okay. See? Wow. It said of the 600,000 people on foot, they too were preserved to bring them into their heritage, even unto the land that floweth with milk and honey. See that? The Lord gave strength also unto Caleb, which remained with him unto his old age. Didn't we read that?
Yeah, Joshua 14.
So that he entered upon the high places of the land, and his seed obtained it for inheritance. Why? That all the children of Israel might see that it is good to follow the Lord. That's the message for us today. Joshua and Caleb kept the faith. It was resolute, right?
Right.
It was different from the rest of them Israelites. They fully followed the Lord. Did they get rewarded?
Yes.
They got rewarded. They diligently sought the Lord. And they get in the kingdom. All praises. Famous men in Israel. That's supposed to encourage us to keep fighting the good fight. Even though we're in the midst of wickedness. That's all right. It's all temptation. Let's look forward. You see? Now go to Maccabees. 1 Maccabees 2, chapter 2. In the Apocrypha. First Maccabees, chapter 2, and 49. It says, now when the time drew near that Mattathias should die, he said unto his sons, now have pride and rebuke gotten strength in the time of destruction and the wrath of indignation. Because who was ruling during this time? Edom, known as the Greeks. You see, this is the first time that you had a nation of Edom conquer the dark nations.
Right.
And Mattathias seen what Edom had did, Antiochus and all that, how they desecrated the temple and all that, destroying our people. So now he's going to fall asleep, so he's going to encourage his sons. Says, now therefore, my sons, be zealous for the law and give your lives for the covenant of your fathers. See that? I mean, be resolute. Called to remember what acts our fathers did in their time. So shall ye receive great honor and an everlasting name. See that? So he's telling his sons, look, called to remember the past, what your forefathers did. They were rewarded, and you will be rewarded, sons. So now it said, verse 52, was not Abraham found faithful in temptation? And it means his faith was imputed unto him for righteousness?
Yes.
Joseph, in the time of his distress, kept the commandment and was made Lord of Egypt. Did Joseph get rewarded?
Yep.
Look what he went through. But he stayed in the commandments and got rewarded. He was second in Egypt, man. And he getting the kingdom. See that?
It's true, boy, man. We can't do nothing. Yeah. Thanks for the car. Thanks for that place to stay, Lord. Thanks for filling my belly. We can't do nothing, Lord.
Look how we be sounding, man. Let's check it out. Verse 54, Phinehas, our father, in being zealous and fervent, obtained the covenant of an everlasting priesthood. He got rewarded. Jesus, meaning Joshua, for fulfilling the word, was made a judge in Israel. See that? Caleb, for bearing witness before the congregation, received the heritage of the land. So what is Mattathias telling his sons? Keep the commandments and you will be what?
Rewarded.
Be safe. See? So that's Hebrews 11 and 6. And that's what Paul in Hebrews 11 chapter, he's encouraging these Israelites, the Hebrews, to endure in the faith. Because many of them was falling away, forsaken not to assemble. He's like, look, man, the dead's approaching. You don't want to go against the Most High, make them your enemy. Ain't that in Hebrews 10? See? It's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the Lord. So we want to endure. Because when it's a wrap, right? This is serious. The Lord could come back today, tonight. What is Israel going to be in the midst of their sins? We want to be there. We want to be those that's ready. What's being ready? Keeping God's commandments with the faith of Christ. Being thankful. Lord, bless us like that. See? But you know what we do as a people? We self-sabotage ourselves. You know what that is? Good things be right around the corner. I don't want that. We self-sabotage. We...
Self-destruct,
brother. See? Every other different month, we got a different spirit on us. Self-sabotaging. Throw it away. Let me throw the kingdom. I don't want that, Lord. I want this world. I like this.
I'm confident, too.
I love asphalt. And I don't like gold. I don't want no gold streets. I want asphalt. I want a kingdom filled with crack rock and meth.
Go get you one.
Ain't that what we do? Go get that smack. We like living in cardboard boxes, bro. I'm being in Hollywood looking for smack and heroin.
Smack.
The needles. Right? Being on the streets, homeless. We like that stuff.
Foster home,
all that stuff, we enjoy it. We say we don't, but look at our actions. See, we like cell bars.
Jails.
I even like the penitentiary, brother. As soon as you gotta pay a bill, it's too fast for me, let me go back to San Quentin. Y'all move too fast. Where's San Quentin? I gotta get on my program, man. Y'all laughing, but that's what the Israel be saying. It's too fast out here. I gotta pay bills? Shit, go to prison.
For real.
Institutionalized. I'm telling you, brother. It's too fast. So you rather prison and eat some food with no seasoning. You done rigged up the television in there in a 6x9 with Jack on top of you. I like prison, dog.
What you call it? box with the ramen noodles, making
a spread. Making a spread with top ramen noodles and hot Cheetos. Give it some flavor, man.
We gone.
We gone as a people. Running D block, but your woman smacking you at home. But you can run D block. Get it straight, dog. Soldiers, get in line. It's rules in this game. But your house is out of control. No rules to the house. Politics. You just look at your brother and say, are you serious? I know you're playing, right? They don't be smiling, brother. I like the pen. Here come RoboCop. Come here, Derek. What you doing over there?
I ain't doing nothing.
Get over there and put your hands on there. Crack all in the pocket, needles. Come on, man. It's cold. Take him to prison. And that's why a lot of times Esau be locking Jake up, save them from theyself sometimes, brother, because they don't hurt theyself. Because they hit on that map, that crystal map. And that stuff have you seeing everything. You be paranoid, cats be coming. You see, he looking at me. Who looking at you? See him in the trees?
Smoking bowl.
See? They watching us. Who watching? What are you talking about? No, shh. See that cat?
Got a blitz.
That cat got a microchip in him. And he be like, what you talking about, man? Telling you. Watch him cross the street. He hearing me right now. That be that meth, brother.
Don't sleep. Smoking cough syrup.
Straight up.
No,
that's for me. And they take me on the meth with mental health drugs. Now that don't go. You got this pharmaceuticals and crystal meth.
Oh my God. That's a cocktail for distraction.
Boom. Telling you, we don't want to be that way. We want to repent, Israel. Heck with this kingdom. This kingdom is infested. Tell us that Deuteronomy, what is it, Revelation 18? Mm-hmm. Right. Thing filled with abomination. We want this one.
Every unclean, hateful bird.
Lord said, I'm getting you out of here, Israel. We don't want to go. We like Egypt. But that's the point. If you had anything with the brother?
Yeah, I need to correct something. When I'm what was that, Numbers 14?
Yeah.
Numbers 14, because I brought out the point about how the Most High judges us. He forgives us for our sins, but we still got to do judgment. Lord David. But that's correct, but it doesn't apply to Numbers 14. That's different. Right. Those two are different. You know, Most High does judge us for our sins, and we got to pay, but that didn't apply to Numbers 14, so I need to correct that. So,
praise.
That's it.
That's it, Israel. Let's do this. Most High in Christ bless everyone. All praise.